Hey, what's up guys? This is Greg with ASUS ROG, and in this video, we're gonna take a look at the ROG Crosshair 8 Impact motherboard. Now, if you're familiar with our Crosshair series, that is AMD. So it's got an AM4 socket for the latest generation AMD Ryzen CPUs, third and second, of course. And then the Impact means it is a small form factor motherboard. So normally in the past, our Impact boards have been ITX, but this is mini DTX. It's a little different. It's got about an extra inch down here on the bottom. Now, later in the video, we'll go into detail about that, but even with that extra size, it actually fits in most ITX cases. Now, why would you want to build a small form factor PC? Well, I think the best, basically, if you want a small PC. But also, you know, if you just want to use it, you can hook up a Bluetooth keyboard and mouse and use it as a living room PC. Whatever you can do with a full-size motherboard, you can basically do it with this. I don't know if you can see everything that's packed in here, but it's a lot. And we're gonna try to go through everything in this video, so stay with me. Now, the first thing I wanna talk about is the design of this board. With these small form factor boards, there are a ton of components we have to pack into a tight little space. So now a lot of companies will just worry about what components are in there, but we really worry about the topography. Basically, where is everything on the board and how is it laid out? We wanna make sure that it has an incredibly efficient power delivery from the power inputs here to all of the components. And that basically will generate less heat and give you an overall better and more reliable gaming experience. Next, let's talk about that DTX form factor. So basically that means it's a little bit taller than a standard mini ITX board. So it's 6.7 inches wide, which is standard ITX, but it's 8 inches tall. Now that extra real estate on the bottom gives you room for the SupremeFX audio card. We've got some extra, you know, front I/O plugs here and even some SATA ports. Now, I know you might be thinking, is that gonna fit in my mini ITX case? Well, if you're gonna be building a system with this board, you're probably gonna be using a beefy two-slot graphics card like this Strix card I have here. And let me show you something here. When you pop that in, the motherboard only extends to the bottom of the dual-slot graphics card. So you're gonna need a case that's gonna fit your dual-slot graphics card anyways. It's gonna fit this. So if you're gonna be building a super fast gaming rig like this, you're not gonna have any problem fitting this into your ITX case. Now for storage, this board has 4 SATA ports, so if you're gonna build a system for your grandma and she's gonna use some 3.5-inch hard drives, you can hook them up there. But if you're like me and you use M.2 for everything, then you're gonna wanna use this. This is the DIMM.2 adapter. Now DIMM.2, we've kind of pioneered on our larger boards, and they're full size DIMM slots, they look like memory slots. But for this one, because it's a small board, we have a cute little SODIMM.2. So this is basically a SODIMM connector. And inside here, there's room for 2 M.2 SSDs. So you can even put them on RAID. So if you're looking for, actually we'll go ahead and put this in the card right here so you can see how it goes. So if you're looking for the fastest memory possible, you're gonna wanna use the SODIMM.2 adapter. It also has this metal heatsink that goes around the outside to help keep them cool so they don't throttle back, which is important in a small form factor PC. But wait, one more thing I forgot to mention. At the bottom of the SODIMM.2 adapter, there's actually dual 4-pin fan headers, so you can add some additional fans, and an addressable RGB LED header. The Impact supports up to 64 gigabytes of DDR4 memory. Now, it only has 2 DIMM slots, so how that's achieved with 64 gigs, you have to use dual capacity RAM. Now, if you're unfamiliar with dual capacity RAM, check out a video that we did a few months ago. I'll add the link in the description below. This board also features OptiMem3 technology, which is basically software built into the board that will optimize your memory automatically. It'll give you the highest frequencies at the lowest voltages so you can get the most out of your memory. Now, when you've got a powerful system in a small form factor, it's gonna generate a lot of heat. So cooling has been extremely important for us when designing this board. And the first thing you'll probably notice about this board, it's got dual fans here on the rear I/O shield. Now, this is actually where the VRM is. You can see it goes through, down through here. There's actually a heat pipe that covers the entire VRM and these other components here with aluminum fins on it. So this fan will actually pull in air over these fins to help cool the system and expel the air out there. There's even a vent on the outside. And these fans are actually offset to help make them more efficient. Now, another thing about these fans, I know a lot of people are a little weary about having small fans on their motherboard, but these are made by Delta and they have been rated at over 60,000 plus hours. So you know they're not gonna break down on you. You could even, if you live in a dusty environment or what have you, you can even remove this cover here to clean out the fan, just blow them out with some compressed air. So that's really cool. Now also on the rear of the board is a full-size aluminum backplate. So this gives you increased mass and surface area to help the board dissipate heat more efficiently. Now on the front, it's got up to 5 4-pin fan headers, two of which are actually on the SODIMM.2 adapter that I showed you earlier. And another cool feature of this board is it has headers for a custom water cooling loop. So this is for your pump speed and flow detectors and even temperature sensors. And this will take data from your custom water cooling loop and bring it into the system so you can, you know, manage everything just from the software. Another cool feature of this board are the 90-degree front I/O connectors. So the front I/O connectors are down here, and instead of facing straight out, they face straight down. So that'll keep all the front I/O connectors here just out of the way for a nice clean look. So for connectivity, the motherboard has built-in Wi-Fi. It uses the latest generation Wi-Fi 6, which of course uses multiple user, multiple input, multiple output technology. And what that basically means is you have multiple connections to your router for a more robust signal for increased speed and reliability. Now also it has Bluetooth 5 built in, so you can connect things like Bluetooth keyboards, mice, headsets, or even a Bluetooth controller if you've got this in your living room for gaming. And if you want to do a wired network, it has a built-in Intel Gigabit LAN port, so that's pretty cool. Now also on the rear I/O, you'll notice that the rear I/O shield is built in. So that makes it a breeze to install. You don't have to put the rear I/O shield in your case first, you just pop the system in and you're ready to go. Now some of the ports we've got on the back here, we've got 8 USB ports. 6 of those are USB 3.2 Gen 2, and the other two are 3.2 Gen 1. And one of those 3.2 Gen 2 ports is a Type-C connection. So if you've got a Type-C headset like our ROG Deltas, you can plug it right into there. Now, there's also additional USB 3.2 connectivity inside. We've got headers, so you can run that to your, if you've got a case that supports USB 3.2 for the front I/O. Now, also on the rear, the last thing I want to mention are the audio connectors. So these are kind of gold-plated, really kind of high-end, like how we do with ROG. But these actually have LEDs inside them that are color-coded. So when you look behind your computer, sometimes it can be kind of dark back there, and these will light up in the color corresponding to what they do, whether it's headphone, line out, line in, whatever. Now the last thing I want to mention on the rear I/O here is for all of you overclockers out there, and this is the flex key. So by default, you can see it's set to reset, but you can also change its function. You can make it so it will do a safe boot, or you can even have it so you can toggle on and off all of your RGB lighting just with the touch of a button. So now for the feature that I'm sure you guys have all been waiting for, what about the RGB LED lighting? So it's got a strip of RGB LEDs down the side here that put a nice glow on the inside of your PC. And there's also 3 RGB LED headers. There are 2 addressable headers and 1 standard header. 1 addressable header is actually on the SODIMM.2 module we showed you earlier. And the other ones are just here and here. So this is the ROG Crosshair 8 Impact motherboard. It is a small form factor powerhouse. If you're going to be building a Ryzen 3 system, you want it to be small form factor, and especially if you're doing liquid cooling, this would be the ultimate motherboard for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If so, give us a like. If not, then give us an angry comment, and I'll try not to read it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.